Do you feel like you are drowning in all these AI updates? Okay, you are not behind. You just need a simple framework to help you master these AI tools for project management specifically. And then you'll reclaim up to several hours per week. And my framework will help you. It consists of just four pieces: problem, tool, prompt, and vault. Most people think they must stay on top every new AI model, every feature update, and every tool they launch. And I'll tell you, this is the biggest misconception in the AI world. You waste hours reading the news and playing with these new features instead of actually managing your projects with AI. And I totally get you. This update paralysis is very discouraging. Every week brings new model, new features, new promises of this revolutionary productivity gains. So why should you master a tool that will be outdated tomorrow, right? But what if I told you that despite so many updates and features, the way you use AI and all AI tools is the same? And I'll explain how in just a minute. But that's precisely why the first step in my framework is so counterintuitive. It is a problem. You must first select one problem you want to solve with AI. I mentored hundreds of project managers in the last few years, and most PMs start using AI with the most complex problem. And this is arguably the biggest mistake. It's too much effort, and you quickly get disappointed with current AI's capabilities. And again, I totally understand that. With all this hype, you do want AI to help you with the biggest challenge. But right now, AI can help you save time on routine tasks that you could potentially delegate to an intern. So, please start with a small problem. So here's the big idea. To keep up with AI, you need to stop trying things out. You need to stop playing with features. It's all about applying tools to problems. And now I almost hear you say, okay, Dmytro, so what tool should I select? Let me help you with this. Most of your core project management tasks can be handled with just a few well-selected AI tools. Because you spend hours writing status reports, crafting stakeholder communication and emails, researching vendor solutions or topics, and summarizing what happened in a meeting. These tasks eat up most of your day, but they don't actually move your project forward. And here's what most AI gurus don't tell you. The market currently offers hundreds of AI tools, but most have the same models under the hood to solve just a specific problem. So you might think that each tool is unique with unique AI model, but many just package the same technology with just different interfaces. This creates an illusion that you have a choice when you are buying the same core tools. That's why the second piece of the framework is the tool. And I'll make your life easy right now. All you need is just three core AI tools for project management: ChatGPT or Gemini for documentation and communication, Perplexity for research, and NotebookLM for knowledge management. These three tools handle nearly everything you do as a project manager. Now, let me break this down to you to the tasks and actions. If you work with existing project documentation, manuals, contracts, and requirements a lot, and you need to find answers in them very quickly, then use NotebookLM from Google. You'll just upload your files or links, and it becomes your personal AI-powered search assistant. NotebookLM has a low tendency towards hallucinations, and it will give you direct reference to your source material so you can check it out. It's a more reliable tool for this tasks than ChatGPT. Next, if you need to write, summarize, analyze, brainstorm, or do this deep research on a topic, use ChatGPT or Gemini. They excel at taking your rough ideas and turning them into professional communication. So, which one should you choose exactly? If you plan to master and use all these different new features like image generation or custom GPTs, then go for ChatGPT. If you are a Google user and mostly use Gmail, Google Docs, and spreadsheets, I recommend Gemini. Because on top of the normal chat, you will also get Gemini inside these tools. So you don't need additional plugins. And if you need to work with large, very large documents, also Gemini has some advantages here. I recommend that you start with a free version of these tools, and then once you feel that you reach its limits of the free version, upgrade to the paid ones. By the way, if you don't want to deal with these generic project management answers that ChatGPT or Gemini usually provide, I have a solution for you. There is a fourth tool. I have developed my own AI project management mentor designed specifically for project managers. It is trained on my 15 years of practical experience with everything that I know and documented, for example, in my book and my courses. Check the link in the description if you are interested. Last but not least, when you need research with better access to fresh web materials, you will use Perplexity. There is a bit overlap right now between Perplexity and all other tools, but still, its main use case is to use it like you used Google before AI. Now, I plan to create dedicated videos about these tools for project management, so let me know in the comments below which one you are most interested in. Is it NotebookLM, ChatGPT, or Gemini? Alright, but having the right tool means nothing if you don't know how to communicate with them efficiently. That's where the third piece of the framework comes into play, the prompt. You see, many users give AI too little context, leading to generic results that don't help in the real world. They type something like, what risks do I have on my project? And then wonder, why ChatGPT gives them generic advice that doesn't apply to their specific situation with all the details that they have in their head. You can't expect useful outputs when you give AI almost nothing to work with. You see, it's like asking someone about sightseeing without specifying the country of interest. But don't worry, the only simple prompt technique you need is the role context task format framework that works for most of your project management needs, regardless of which AI tool you are using. So let's break it down with some examples. Role tells AI what expert perspective to take. Telling AI to act as an expert narrows down its output to your needs. And the two roles you'll use most often are: you're an experienced IT project manager, or you're a world-class business analyst. Then describe the context. The more specific you are, the better output you get. For example, I'm managing a software development project with Scrum. I lead 6 engineers. We have just started a sprint, and customer have asked to adjust the requirements. In the attachment, I provided transcript of our meeting and the text of the existing user stories. Next, give the AI tool the specific task, like analyze the files. First, write a summary of all changes. Second, update the existing user stories to include the new requirements. Third, create additional user stories if needed. Format specifies how you want to get the answer. And don't leave it to AI to decide. It can't read your mind. For example, write the summary in a numbered list. Provide the user stories one by one. First, the old version and then the new one. ensure that all user stories follow the same format we had initially. Once you get into a habit of writing good prompts, you have mastered 80% of all AI tools, because a prompt is a starting point for everything today. It is as important as the skill of clicking the like button. Please show your skills right now. Thank you in advance. But jokes aside, good prompts that provide consistent results may be one or two pages long. But here's the problem. Writing detailed prompts every time becomes its own time sink. That's precisely why most project managers fail to get productivity benefits from AI. Here, you need systems that eliminate this friction completely. So ask yourself, how much time do you waste rewriting the same prompts, even if it's like these just four sentences? Or you're forgetting which prompt worked well last time? And you probably have been in this situation, spending 5 minutes crafting a great prompt to summarize meeting notes, and then you use it once. Then forget exactly how you wrote it, and when you need it next time, for the same purpose, you have to rewrite it from scratch. The fourth piece of the framework is Vault. You must create a prompt library to eliminate friction that prevents you from using AI for productivity. Think of this as your personal collection of proven templates that delivered results every time. You can build a database in Notion, ClickUp, or just in Google Doc, where you store prompts by category: meeting summaries, stakeholders, emails, maybe risk assessments. But if you want to take it to the next level, you should start using text expanders. So, for instance, using a text expander like Alfred or basically any free alternatives cuts this prompt friction even further. And here's how it works. Basically, you create shortcuts that instantly insert the best prompts. Instead of typing or copy-pasting a complex prompt to generate status report, you type something like asterisk status report, and then the entire prompt appears automatically. Another way to reduce friction is to keep these shortcuts, the keywords, close to the task. So you can put them into your calendar events or task descriptions to eliminate the need to go and look into the vault. Okay, let's summarize it. You have the full framework now: problem, tool, prompt, and vault. And once a week, dedicate 30 minutes to create just one new prompt or update the existing ones that can help you save time to solve just one problem. Then review what worked well and what needs improvement. This systematic approach transforms AI tools from being a distraction into a true productivity multiplier. But again, remember that all these tools are still as good as your project management knowledge. And moreover, ChatGPT will always give you generic project management theory. That's why it's critically important that you systemize your knowledge in project management ASAP. Click this video now to learn my end-to-end project management approach. Click the video now, I'm waiting for you there.